Hi everyone, this is R. Prenke with another tutorial video for Eyewire. This is going to be the 7th practice cube that comes after the tutorial cubes. So you're not going to get feedback while you work, you will get some afterwards, and you're going to start getting some points. So this one is particularly tricky because of all the branches. And something to remember is you only want to do one branch at a time, and there are going to be a couple of other tricks that I can show you while we work. So we've got two things that start with right here. I'm going to follow this one first because I can see there's something to add. Okay. And so that's clear at the edge of the volume of the cube. Alright, so that checkerboard pattern that you just saw, that happens on occasion. That's just the site trying to load the image. So if you just give it a second, usually it fixes the problem. Okay. So we reached the edge of the cube on that, so we're going to go back up the other way. Okay, and so see they joined right there? Now I'm going to follow this one back down, because what we're doing, if you look over in the 3D to the left, so this is where we started, this one, and then it goes up and it joined this one, so I'm going to just make sure there's nothing missing off of this real quick. Okay, reaches the edge of the cube and it's fine, so now we can start moving up the main branch. Alright, and you might notice some other stuff off to the right. We're going to ignore it, because we're doing one branch at a time, and we're following this little one that's kind of in the lower left. Okay, and so it looks like it's about to go join the main thing. Alright, so now we can see we're right here where this plane is. And what I want to do first is fill in some of the holes that are on this big stalk right here. So let's start working on that. And then after that, we're going to go attend to the little branches off to the sides. But we're just going to do one thing at a time. And just filling in the little bits. A lot of times, most of what's missing is along the edges of these big ones. Okay. Making some progress. Unfortunately, there's a bunch of these to do. Okay. Alright, so it looks like this is branching off right here, this one right here, and as we're already here, we're going to follow it. Okay. Alright, and it looks like this one is branching too, so what we're going to do is we're going to follow this left-hand side first, and then we'll move back to the other one. Okay, so it looks like that left-hand side one just disappeared and there wasn't anything to add, so now we're going to go back over to this side, add some more. And I know it's hit the edge already, but I can see, if you look in the 3D, that it continues down actually quite a ways after it hitches the edge of the cube. So we want to make sure we follow it along and get that. And that's why it's actually really, really important to make sure something either disappears off the edge of the cube or just disappears in general before you stop tracing it. It's not enough for it to simply hit the edge of the cube. Okay. Looks like it joined that. Let's continue on. Ah, finally something else to add. Okay, so it looks like that one disappeared nicely. Now we could just scroll back through this entire thing to get back there, but I don't really want to do that, so what we're going to do is double click, and that will move this plane that you see in the 3D, that'll move that up or down depending on where you double click, and what that does is it relocates you in the 2D to what you double clicked on in the 3D. So if I know I need to go inspect, say, this little nub right here, double click, and I'm right there now, so I can go check it out and see what's going on. So this is about where we stopped earlier. So let me double click down there. And now we're going to continue moving down, and we're going to go find the rest of the branches. And first, though, I'm going to get this little blank spot right up here, because that's just something that we missed earlier. Okay, so this is the one I'm following now, this big blue one. Okay, so it looks like we have something branching off down there. So let's follow it down first. So let's go back to where it joined. Okay. So this one, if we look over in the 3D, looks like there are at least three branches coming off of this, and let's zoom in a little bit. And then if you right click and drag, you can kind of relocate it wherever you want. Alright, so this is tricky looking. And a trick I like to use when it's a little bit difficult like this is if you click on the little gear in the lower right hand corner of your screen, click on it, and you can uncheck the box that says show EM images in 3D. And what EM images are the dark outlines that are visible on the plane in the 3D. So it's going to make it a little bit easier to see through the plane. Okay, so note that they're gone now, and you can always bring them back by rechecking the box. I'm also going to go down to plane opacity, third from the bottom, and lower that. And this is going to make it a lot easier to see through it, so I can see what's going on. Alright. So let's carry on, and so we're going to follow this one first, this long one that's going down. Okay. Oops, I think I was going the wrong direction. So it's going up, actually. Okay, now it's going over to the right. And it looks like both of those just happened to disappear. Lucky us. So let's go back up to where it branched off. Alright. So it looks like, let's go check this. One that's going down, that one disappears too. And so we checked this one. If you look over in the 3D, we checked this one, and now we just need to check this one right here. That's why it's really useful to check things in the 3D, because it's easier to see if you've done something or not. So this is the third one right here, it looks like, and that one also just disappears. All right, and so it looks like we've actually now checked everything in here, and if there is something that you'd forgotten to check, you can always just double click and it will take you right there. Makes it a lot easier than scrolling back and forth. All right, we're finished.